Okay, before I get started with this video, I want to make a huge, huge, gigantic disclaimer. Everything I'm about to say is just my opinion based on my experiences and my observations of things. I do not speak for the entirety of the LGBTQ community, nor do I speak for the entirety of the asexual community. I speak for myself and for myself only. And to those people who will disagree with me, because I know there will be people who disagree with me, to those people I say, to each their own. You have every right to believe what you like, just as I have every right to believe what I like. Okay? Okay, so that out of the way, I want to talk about something that has been on my mind a lot lately. And actually, this video might become a little long and it might be more of a rant or venting, so apologies in advance. So what I'd like to talk about is asexuality and the LGBTQ community. Are asexuals part of the LGBTQ community? To the best of my knowledge at present, there is no definitive answer to this question. There is very strong, sometimes even fierce debate among both asexuals and the LGBTQ community about this topic. If you go on Tumblr, you can sometimes find people biting each other's heads off about this. And if you go on Aven, the largest asexual community, you'll find asexuals who will passionately argue either side of this debate. I have heard people both in and outside of the LGBTQ community argue that asexuality can't be part of the LGBTQ for various reasons, such as asexuality being a lack of sexuality and therefore inappropriate as being part of the LGBTQ, or saying that asexuals aren't oppressed enough, and other such bullshit. And yes, in my opinion, those opinions are bullshit. And I could dedicate an entire video to such opinions and why they're stupid or idiotic or uneducated or ignorant, but not now, not this video, maybe in the future. On the other hand, I know that there are asexuals who want nothing whatsoever to do with the LGBTQ community for various reasons. For example, some asexuals feel that they have nothing whatsoever in common with the LGBTQ community. Some feel that such an association of asexuality with the LGBTQ will make things harder or worse off for them because such an association will inevitably come with new and more stigmatizations and new and more misunderstanding of their own sexuality by others and baggage that they just don't want. And there are also asexuals who just don't like having labels associated with them at all, including the label asexuality or asexual. And to these people, I say, fair enough. I totally understand where you're coming from. My personal stance on this is that anyone who feels that they are queer, anyone who identifies with the word queer, anyone who identifies as being part of the LGBTQ community, has every right to identify and associate as such. And those who do not feel that they identify with such a community, that they want themselves associated with such a community, okay, that's fine too. Personally, my relation with the LGBTQ community, the rainbow flag, all of that stuff, is a bit complicated. I mean, when it's just me, myself, and I, or when I'm in front of a computer, yeah, sure, woo, identify as LGBTQ all the time, everywhere, out and proud, online anyway. But when it comes to being in an LGBTQ space at an LGBTQ event, things start to be a bit trickier. The past 2 weeks, I've been going to the asexual group at The Center, which is Las Vegas's LGBTQ center. And I have to say that this is my first time going to the center, and I'm really, 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 really impressed. The place is awesome, the resources available, and the general inclusion of many different groups and people is really, really, really awesome. Seriously, I haven't seen another LGBTQ center thus far that has been as inclusive and awesome as this one. I mean, in addition to simply having an asexual group, which is a really rare thing, they also have a genderqueer / gender variant group, and how awesome is that? But anyway, some of the things that we've been talking about at the asexual group has been really interesting, and in fact, has been partly responsible for inspiring this video. This weekend is Las Vegas Pride. So, Friday was the Pride Parade, and yesterday was the Pride Festival. And in deciding whether or not I wanted to go to these events, feelings have been brought to the surface. I've been reminded about how complicated and conflicting my association with the LGBTQ community at large can be at times. And yeah, because of this, I can really sympathize with the asexuals who want nothing to do with it right now. Originally, I'd wanted to go to the Vegas Pride Parade, but actually, I decided not to go. In reflecting on past experiences that I've had at similar events, I decided that really, I didn't want to go out of my way to go to a place where there would be pretty much no representation of me at all. And in fact, not just that, I didn't want to go out of my way to a place where, you know, as an asexual, I would feel alienated because, you know, at such events, there's often a lot of over-sexualization. And, you know, this being a Vegas event, that most certainly would be the case. And yeah, I've had enough of feeling alienated and like I don't belong somewhere. So why would I go out of my way to go to an event where, yeah, I would feel just that? I mean, but don't get me wrong. I think that the event was good. I streamed some of it online. And yeah, it was a good parade, and I'm glad that such an event is happening in Vegas. But yeah, I'm just glad that I didn't go out of my way to be a part of that crowd when I wouldn't have felt, you know, really good about being there anyway. Yesterday was the Pride Festival, and even though I still had the same concerns about the festival as I did with the parade, I decided that I wanted to go check it out anyway. And I left the event with mixed feelings. On one hand, it was great having gone because I got to see how big the Vegas LGBTQ community is. I mean, I'm originally from Vegas, but still, I had no idea that the community was as large as it is, or at least was, at that event. And also, it was awesome to see the decent QPOC turnout to the event. And QPOC, if you don't know, is queer people of color. It was really nice seeing a lot of African Americans, Latinos, and other nationalities, ethnicities there at the event. I mean, that was just really, really cool. On the other hand, again, there was a total lack of representation of me at that event, and that made me sad. Actually, I felt that there was a lot of underrepresentation in general, not just of me, but of other groups as well. And I find that this is a common thing at many, many LGBTQ events and spaces. There was a lot of the L, a lot of the G, but where was the B? Where was the T? Let alone an I or an A or a P. It's just, there's a lot of lack of visibility of groups within the LGBTQ community. It's largely gay people and lesbians. And I mean, this is no fault of the organizers of this particular event. It's just, yeah. And it should be noted that there was actually a very large drag or queen presence at the event. And I mean, that's not really surprising. Vegas has a very strong drag community. But people who do drag and queens, they don't necessarily identify as trans. And I think that was the case with many of the people at the event. They didn't identify as trans. They may identify as being LGBTQ, but not trans. So again, there's a lack of T. Anyway, everywhere I went, people were being out and proud, very loudly out and proud. There were stands for various organizations, there were rainbow flags and accessories being sold everywhere. But where were the other pride flags? Where was the bi pride, the trans pride, the genderqueer pride? Where were the trans support organizations? Only at two stands did I find anything related to the B or the T and the LGBT. And yeah, that was really disappointing and sad. Everywhere, everyone was loudly celebrating who they are. But I couldn't help but wonder, if I celebrated who I am just as loudly as them, for example, if I wore an ace pride shirt, if I draped an asexual or a genderqueer or a neutral flag over my shoulders, if I did anything to fight the inevitable assumptions that I'm lesbian, what kind of reactions would I get to that? Would I get blank stares? Would I get people asking what such and such means? And upon explaining what something means, would I get laughs? Would I get sympathy even? I seriously felt like I had to think about that. And the fact that I even have to be concerned about worrying about the kind of reactions that I would get to my own pride at a pride festival is just really sad. I'm reminded of when I went to an LGBTQ film festival in Brisbane. I went to see the movie Gaby. And in that movie, one of the main characters makes fun of the A in LGBTQIA two times. And yes, I was counting, two times. And it wasn't some little poking fun at. It was blatant saying that it didn't belong there, what the hell was that A for, kind of thing. And when the character made fun of the A, people in the theater laughed. And I just sat in my seat, silently foaming at the mouth. It's stuff like this, the lack of visibility, the lack of recognition, inclusion, lack of understanding. It's stuff like this that makes me question wearing my rainbow bracelet. It's stuff like this that makes me not able to identify with the LGBTQ community or with the rainbow flag sometimes. I mean, the rainbow flag, does it even represent me? Sometimes I ask myself this. Am I even represented by the rainbow flag? Are other groups of people even represented by the rainbow flag? The rainbow flag is supposed to represent the entirety of the LGBTQ community, but sometimes it seems like it's just the homosexual flag or something. And I don't mean to offend anyone, I know that that's not the case, but sometimes that's how it feels. Because there's such a lack of inclusion, there's such a lack of education, there's such a lack of awareness, there's such a lack of visibility in that flag, in the LGBTQ community, at LGBTQ events, that, yeah. I mean, I will continue to wear my rainbow bracelet, if you can see it, with pride, along with my many other pride bracelets. I will continue to associate with the LGBTQ community. But, yeah. The association, the relationship I have with the community, it's not always strong. It wavers a lot sometimes. And yeah, I guess that's where I'll leave this video, that I totally sympathize with asexuals who sometimes feel that they don't belong or that they have nothing in common with the community. Even though saying that, I do strongly feel that asexuality should be included. But yeah, anyway, that's where I'll leave this video. If you have anything to add or anything to comment, please do. I look forward to hearing other people's opinions. Bye.